This week on The Wire, millennials lead the charge, Australia keeps AAA, and market remains resilient. G'day guys, my name is Tim Guest, and welcome to The Wire, the week in real estate where you can get all the top stories happening this week in finance, real estate, investment, and more. Now please like, comment, and share this video, and if it's your first time tuning in, don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you're seeing this. So our top story for this week, millennials lead the charge. So the number of first-time buyers acquiring a property reached a decade high level earlier this year, says CommSec, and their numbers have continued to grow throughout the pandemic period. Young professionals and couples armed with a wealth of industry knowledge, a list of must-haves, and the confidence to make an offer fast are buying up properties in Perth, Brisbane, Melbourne, and elsewhere in Australia. While millennials are encouraged to buy into the property market through schemes like the federal government's first home loan deposit scheme and also the recent home builder packages, investors and mature property owners appear to be taking their time to move in the market for now. Agents across the nation are reporting young home hunters in secure jobs are emboldened and typically seeking a townhouse or two-bedroom unit, while low interest rates mean it's now cheaper to buy it than rent in many areas. This momentum is it's expected to continue with the second round of the first home loan deposit scheme opening on the 1st of July. That's with another 10,000 places becoming available. Now, guys, for our next story, Australia keeps AAA. So Australia is one of just 10 countries to retain its AAA credit rating through the coronavirus-induced global recession, and that's based on Moody's Investors Service, the most recent assessment. Now, Moody's says that Australia's AAA stable credit rating reflected the economy's strengths and good governance, including health management, that will support the country's resilience in response to the coronavirus pandemic. Moody's forecast the economy to shrink by 5% this year, though it said the government's $150 billion in budget spending and support from the Reserve Bank of Australia would mitigate the contraction. In Moody's assessment, the resilience of the Australian economy supports a return to positive growth next year without any significant long-lasting impact on growth potential once the crisis passes, it says. Now, by international standards, Australia has a relatively low public gross debt of about 42% of GDP. Moody's forecasts it to exceed 50% by 2021 and rise moderately thereafter. Australia received a AAA credit rating from all three major rating agencies, which are Moody's, S&P Global Ratings, and Fitch Ratings. Now, guys, for our final story of the week, market remains resilient. So the fundamentals of the Australian housing market are intact despite the economic upheaval caused by the COVID-19 lockdown. And that comes from Stockland's head of communities, Andrew Whitson. He says the two biggest drivers of the residential property market have been low mortgage rates and credit growth. They still remain supportive. Now, Whitson said the federal government's support to the housing and construction market was smart policy, given it was time-bound and targeted, and it would aid the industry and the economy. There's a real multiplier effect, he says, adding that every house built creates three jobs, and every dollar spent on residential construction adds three to the economy. The state of the housing market has been a key barometer of economic health. Now, when considering the fourth quarter of 2020, EY Oceania economist Joe Masters says the July 23 mini budget will outline a plan as to how we get through that fiscal cliff and how we support the economy and confidence throughout to the end of the year. Well, guys, they're the top stories happening for this week. Now, please like, comment, and share this video, and don't forget to follow or subscribe wherever you're seeing this. Have a great week, and remember, there is only one thing in life that makes a difference, and that's action. Thanks, guys, and bye for now.